Hi guys, it's Kelly here and I'm back with another video. Today's video is featuring some products from Crafty Meraki. We are going to be using this stamp set called Love Like No Other. It has coordinating dies, which are a little different. I also showed you these birthday dies I thought I was going to use, but that I didn't. And then the, what is this stencil called? Foliage something. Here is kind of the most interesting thing about this release. This is something that they are releasing. It is called Effortless Artist Paper. And so basically you can buy this paper pack. It is the same as the stamp set. Crafty Meraki always has colored images on the back of their stamp sets. And these are hand colored by her design team. And they're beautiful. But what she's done is she's put them in a paper pad with the sentiments, and these coordinate with the dies. And so she has them, and she's got little people, little characters, florals. And so how fun is that? Now, you might be saying, Kelly, you're a colorist. Why would you want pre-colored images? Because it's fast. For real. So here's what we're going to be doing today. We're going to be creating some backgrounds, and then kind of the focus of the video is going to be things that I do to kind of make my busy backgrounds more useful, because I ended up making it busier than I intended, and then it wasn't serving the purpose that I needed it to. So first things first, this is the Alta New stamp wheel. I'm using it to hold my stencil. It is the cat's pajamas for holding stencils. However, they are selling this sticky mat separately. So if you are like, the price point for the stamp wheel is outrageous and I can't afford it, I don't think it's outrageous personally. I think that it is kind of on point with the rest of everything in the market. But if you're like, I can't afford that, that's fine. You could just get the sticky mat for the stenciling. They're amazing. Anywho, so what you saw is you can see how well it holds because I was just able to go in and like swap out my other piece of cardstock. And the stencil just held there. Like I just used it like a hinge, put my next piece of paper in, and then continued with my ink blending. So anywho, so we're going to make these backgrounds and then we're going to do some coloring, but we're also going to use that, I think she's calling it EAP, Effortless Artist Paper, for short. And so for the stencil, I just used it, peeled it off, turned it a quarter turn, put it back down, and then I did my next color. So I used all three greens for that. For the last color, I did kind of scoot it a little, because I noticed I was getting some empty areas. So I just kind of scooted it over to the right a little bit, and then that helped fill in some of the areas. So let's talk about, this video is part of a video hop, and there are prizes to be won. There's also prizes to be won over on Instagram. This is a whole, what does she call it? Meraki-versary? It's their birthday, y'all. I can't pronounce the what we're calling it. But anyway, it's their third birthday. And so they're doing quite the large celebration, which is awesome. So there is a video ahead of mine, a video behind mine. All of that will be linked below if you would like to hop along and just kind of see all of the inspiration that is available using these newer products. I just stuck to this one. I do not know. I did not look and see. I would be, if I had to guess, if I was a betting woman, just because you start to get an eye for it after a while. I wonder if these are drawn by Emily. I know she does do some illustrations for Crafty Meraki, and this very much looks like her style. She has quite the ruffly style. But anyway, these little tulips are beautiful. So I am going to use the pre-colored ones, and then I'm also going to color my own, just to kind of show you how well they work. And I'm going to be honest with you, at the end of the day when the cards are done, I actually like the pre-cut, like the pre-colored ones better than my own coloring. because it has a bit more dimension and I think it's lovely. So anyway, so I'm going to stamp these two tulips and then we're going to get right into the coloring. I did choose, there's a couple of different styles. So because they're hand colored by her design team, they all have a little bit of a different style, which is awesome. I think that gives you so many options. So I chose the one that was covered by, oh, I'm not gonna say it right. Lunan. It's beautiful. Anyway, she's part of the blog hop as well. Or they, or he. I don't really know because I can't tell by the name. But they are a very talented colorist. And they are part of the Instagram hop. So I will actually be hopping my own hop to see what they have created. But anyway, so I chose this one. And it's the same one that's on the back of the packaging. And I did the colors the same. Because you guys know when I take my pictures, I like them to be matchy-matchy. Now, mine are not as dark. And I don't know if that has to do with the original coloring or if that has to do with the process of creating and making them into this paper. But the gist of it is, I always say this word wrong too. Why is pronunciation so hard for me? Ephemera? Like that you can purchase to use on your cards. It's kind of like that, but you can die cut it out as you need it, and it coordinates with the stamp. So you can use the pre-colored ones, or you can color your own, or you can use a combination of the two, which I kind of love. So as far as adding shading, really, where these tulips are kind of tight, they're not real open tulips. So we're going to have lots of shading where they are next to each other. We're going to have lots of shading where the petals lay on top of each other. And I, like I said, I chose the colors based on the colors that were already in the coloring. I think that's another really good way to use this. And you could just use, if you're like, I like to color and I won't use the pre-colored images. The coloring that's always on the back of her stamp sets can really be a great starting off point. Like if you're not sure about what something should be colored or what a color scheme that you would like or where the shading should go, like flip over the stamp set and look at it. It's amazing that they're doing such a fantastic job. The only other portion of the shading that I did that was a little bit different is tulips have this little like rib or ridge in their petals. And so when I was doing the coloring, I did leave a highlight in the center of like the full petals that you see to give the indication that that little fold or ridge would be there that you would see in real life. And I just made sure to leave that my highlight color. So, video hop, Instagram hop. Yeah, I think I covered all of my housekeeping things. I apologize if I sound a little different. I also apologize for my allergies. It is early in the morning. I have just taken Nathan to school. Eric took Caitlin this morning. And I was up late last night because I had too much on my plate. That's just really what happened. So I was up late last night, kind of knocking things out. And I knew I still needed to do my voiceover. So I came home. I'm trying to get into, I'm just going to be very transparent with you guys. I am not in a good routine with my Bible or my prayer. And so I'm trying to get into a better routine. So the lately what I've been doing is when I come home from taking the kids, I will come home, I will make myself a cup of coffee, and instead of coming directly into the craft room, I go into my bedroom, I have a conversation with God, I read my Bible, and then I start my day. And that's something that is not habit yet. I am still working on it. So I did do that this morning before I came in here to do my voiceover. So did that put me a little bit more behind? Yes. Was it worth it? Yes. So one of the things that I wanted to talk about, and we talk about it a lot here on this channel, here we're going to talk about the busyness. So this background was a little busy. I really liked it, but it was a little busy for what I wanted. I wanted the images to be the focal point, and it wasn't happening. It was competing with the background. So one of my first ways that I go to tone down a busier background is ink blending. And I'm using the same colors. I'm starting with the lightest color and then working out to the darkest. And then I'll show you the two examples where I put the stamped images on the one that has the background blended and the one that does not have the background blended. And you'll be able to certainly tell the difference about how that focal point pops almost immediately. So here you can see the images are much more visible and you have a tendency to look at this beautiful coloring, whereas the one on the left, they're kind of competing for each other. And I did just want to show you that it's not just because those images are darker. It's genuinely because of the background. So the other way that I will tone down a background is a vellum. Vellum's fantastic for this. So just putting a little piece of vellum, you could also die cut it into a different shape. I just did a little square. But that helps to not remove the background. It's not like a solid piece of cardstock, but it just tones it down enough to let those middle image, like those focal points, really shine. And then so from here, we'll start putting the cards together. So anywho, I've been trying to get back into this routine, and you guys know that I really love supporting small businesses. And I am very fortunate to be friends, or at least friendly, with quite a few stamp company owners. Bindu is the owner of Crafty Meraki. I was lucky enough to meet her in person for the first time ever at Creativation. It was a very short 30-second conversation. And then last week, we got on the phone together and had an extended, a really good talk. And she's wonderful. She's lovely. She's hustling, trying to, you know, just be there and produce quality products for her customers. And I could not respect that more. I had seen an interview, and I just loved it. I just loved it so much. It was an interview with Kerry Washington. And they were talking about, like, the timing of things. And she said, if you are running late for the bus, you cannot just walk to the bus and pray that you'll catch the bus. And if you're running late for the bus, you can't just run for the bus and not pray for the bus. That you have to do both. Because if you run for the bus and don't pray, that could have been your bus. And if you pray but walk to the bus, that could have been your bus. But if you are running to the bus and praying for the bus, if you miss the bus, it was not your bus. And so, like, people like Crafty Meraki, these small businesses, like, not, they are like in the last quarter mile of the race, sprinting to the finish line, and all the while praying that they will have whatever it is that their business needs, that their customer needs to sustain their business. And so, you know, having a 3-year anniversary is no small feat, especially in this economical climate. And I'm very blessed and honored to be a part of her journey and supporting her business. I think that it also is super important as a woman, supporting women-owned businesses. Not that I'm super feminist. That's not really my bag, and we don't talk politics here, so we're not going to get into that. But I think that it is important, because sometimes women have a reputation of being catty. But I think it's super important as women to support other women, especially other women in business, because it is hard. It is so hard. So I'm just honored that she asked me to be a part of her video hop. Super excited to be celebrating her. If you have not heard of Crafty Meraki, I would encourage you to go over and check out the website and, you know, see if there's something that's maybe your style. So here, everything's put together. I am using, I apologize, I didn't get the name of it before. Hold on. This is the Meraki Sparkle Magical Iris. That is what, speaking of women supporting women, what you saw me putting these cute little rhinestones on, which these are beautiful, by the way, was a crystal katana, which also is another woman-owned business. And she got her patents, which means she engineered this. She created it from nothing. And now she has multiple patents on it. So she is the producer of it. And so I bought one. I bought one and it's lovely. It works great. It's the best picker upper. It's a wax picker upper and it works fantastic. Something else of note for these, I was able to put shimmer on the EAP and I was able to put white highlights on it. It did take a smidge longer to dry, but it did dry. So those are things that you can still do. And then these are both cards. So thank you guys so much for joining me. I hope that you learned a little bit of something and that you're excited to go create. Thank you so much for your time. I always appreciate you and I will catch you on the next video. Bye.